All right, welcome back everybody to another Deepvue tutorial. This is going to be a great one. We'll be focusing on the new Market Navigator Deepvue Indicator, and this helps you kind of manage your positions by identifying both buy and sell signals. So this is going to be a great one. Stick around until the end. And if you're new to the Deepvue platform, we have a special offer, 2 months for $39. Definitely take advantage of this deal. It might not last too much longer, so click the link popping up right now, as well as located down below in the description to check it out. And if you tried Deepvue before, definitely also jump on that deal and give us another try. We've made a lot of improvements and also added a ton of new features, including this indicator. So let's go ahead and dive right in. The Market Navigator Indicator, as I mentioned, allows you to plot on the chart common buy and sell rules. And this helps, you know, keep everything objective, helps you manage positions, as well as analyze the charts that much easier and that much faster. We'll get into the specific signals and kind of what they all mean in just a minute. But of course, to add it to your charts, what you want to do is go over to the indicators and strategies icon, give this a click, search DV, and then you can either search a Market Navigator or just kind of scroll down and, you know, find it in here in the list. Click that and it'll be added to your charts. We'll go ahead and delete the duplicate one. And to edit the system and edit the settings, what you want to do is hover over that indicator name in your object tree and click the gear icon. This brings up the settings for the indicator. And let's go ahead and first run through the different inputs. For both buy and sell rules, we have 10 different coded setups and entry tactics. And we'll kind of run through each of them in just a minute in the knowledge base article. But basically, you want to run through this and activate the ones you want to include and kind of what fits with your trading style. If you're more of a swing trader, you'll kind of focus more on the 21 EMA. But if you're more of a position trader, longer term trader, you might want to focus more on the 50 and 200 SMA and the rules that apply to those different moving averages. We've also got the accumulation days, distribution days, downside reversal bars, higher highs, lower highs as well, or lower lows rather. So there's a ton of very helpful stuff coded into here. And let's go over to the knowledge base article to kind of run through the actual details of what each signal kind of means. And this article will be linked down below. And if ever you're confused or want to learn more about an indicator or a feature of Deepvue, you want to go over to the knowledge base article and kind of search for it in here. And we'll have written an article based on that specific feature that can help you out. So let's go ahead and dive right in. As it says right here, you can have signal combination options. You can set up either a combination of signals that together trigger a larger signal, or you can have, as I have set up, just kind of individual signals that plot different, you know, triangles or whatever you want to set it up as on your chart based on the individual signals. You can set up either way depending on your personal preferences. Let's run through the buy signals. First, buy signal one. This signal is triggered when the price crosses above the 21 EMA. Where the current bar closed above the 21 EMA while the previous bar closed below the 21 EMA. So you're getting that crossover. That's so, so helpful. Then we've got trending above the 21 EMA. This is when price closes above the 21 EMA for each of the last five periods. Then living above the 21 EMA is the same thing for 15 periods. Then you've got a cross above the 50 SMA, the same logic as a 21 EMA, but just with the 50-day SMA. We've also got a cross above the 200 SMA. Then we've got buy signal six, low above the 50 SMA, and this is triggered when the lowest price of the bar is above the 50 SMA. Buy signal number seven is an accumulation day, and this is based on the daily closing range, and when it is greater than 50% with larger volume than the previous bar, we mark that as a accumulation day. A higher high, this occurs when the current bar's high is greater than the highs of the previous 14 bars. That's definitely a key one to kind of identify those key breakouts and trends from basically a consolidation of at least 2 weeks. Buy signal number nine is a key reversal bar signal, and it's generated when the stock opens below the low of the previous bar, but rallies to close above the previous bar's high. So it basically does an oops reversal and closes above the high as well. And then the last buy signal is when a distribution day falls off, and it's triggered when a distribution day falls off the rolling 25 bar period. getting into the sell signals, first we've got a cross below the 21 EMA. This is kind of inverse of the cross above. Similarly, we've got trending below and living below with 5 periods and 15 periods respectively. We've got the same thing for a cross below the 50 SMA, a cross below the 200 SMA, the high below the 50 SMA. So it's kind of the inverse of all these buy signals, which makes sense. We've got a distribution day marked when the DCR is less than 50% with larger volume than the previous day, a lower low. We've got a downside reversal bar. This can be really key, and we'll actually take a look at some examples with NVIDIA, which led to basing from this key reversal bar. Stan Weinstein, as maybe many of you guys watched in our previous interview, this is something he really looks out for when he's managing positions. And then lastly, we've got a distribution day cluster. It's triggered when there's a cluster of distribution days, and it's occurred basically 3 times in a rolling 7-bar period. As mentioned here, you can either set it up for requiring a combination of signals to show an indicator on the chart, or you can just kind of map up the individual signals. And then of course you can style it however you want, change the color of the signal, change the icon that shows up on the chart. But let's go ahead and actually dive right into setting it up ourselves, and also run through some examples here. So first things first, again, to edit the settings, you wanna click this gear icon. These are the current signals that I kind of run with: cross above the 21, 50, key reversal bar, cross below the 21 EMA, cross below the 50, 200, and then a downside reversal bar. Again, you can pick and choose and kind of set it up however you'd like. If you'd like all these signals, go for it. And I have it set up for its individual signals. If you just require a combination of signals, all of these must be true for it to be triggered. But I like setting it up with individual just to show all those different signals whenever they do occur. And this is also helpful for kind of piecing into positions. If you want to add half on a cross above the 21, then the next half on a cross above the 50, you can set it up that way, which can be really, really helpful. Going over to styling, you can change the color of the buy signal. You can also change the icon. I like either the triangle up or the arrow up is also really good. It's a little bit more subtle, which I kind of like. But you know, for the purposes of the tutorial, I do like that triangle. It's very, very clear. Then you can also change the visibility if you'd like to. And that's pretty much it for all you need to set up. So let's go ahead and run through a couple examples. And first, let's zoom in to the NVIDIA example recently. We've got the most recent cross above the 21 EMA here, cross above the 50. That's why these two have signals. And then we have a downside reversal bar, and then a cross below both the 21 and 50. That's why the second bar is highlighted in red. So you can kind of enter up the right-hand side using this indicator, and it gets you out as the kind of trend confirms down as we've seen, and just kind of this falls back within the base. Down here, we've also got a downside reversal bar. Here we've got a cross below the 50-day moving average, a cross below the 21 EMA, downside reversal bar. So you can see how, you know, as a base is forming and the trend becomes negative, you're seeing the sell signals come in. And as the trend begins to move up, that's when the buy signals come in. So it allows you to really identify objectively when trends are beginning and ending. Scrolling out, you can see the same thing happening in the last base. We've got the key downside reversal bar. Stan Weinstein identified this when we went through the chart in our most recent interview, and this was actually the start of a long-term basing period of a few months. So these are key to look out for, and that's why it's great to have the market navigator signal turned on for these type of bars. Then we've got some crosses above and below the 21 EMA as it was kind of choppy in here. But finally, you know, up the right-hand side, you're seeing a cross above the 21 and 50 moving average. That's the most recent buy signal. And then it allows you to jump on this trend, and there's no sell signals until a close below the 21 EMA, and then those downside reversals, and then the start of this short-term downtrend that we just went over. Moving on to the base prior to that, which had a really nice move. Again, this is a more longer-term base. You had some choppiness, crosses above and below. So again, these signals should always be taken into the context of what the market's doing, what the stock is doing, the larger pattern, the theme, all of that. You don't just want to blindly use these, but this can kind of be an additive tool to your toolkit that allows you to objectively define your buys and sells within the context of the overall pattern. Here we've got a longer term base forming. At this point, we're tightening in price and volume. We're seeing a 3 weeks tight. We're seeing VCP characteristics as the contractions get smaller and smaller. And then we start to see a cross above the 21 EMA and then the breakout right there. That's the last buy signal here. And then this trend, this kind of holds you in. There's no sell signals until we see that downside reversal bar here, which starts that longer term base. Let's move on to CAVA here. And to the recent base here, you can see at the start of the base, you're seeing the sell signals, gets you out of the way of the resulting decline, and then gets you back in with the buy signals to ride this trend. And hopefully we'll see if this continues, but it's been a promising stock and start of this move. Also, I want to show PLTR. This also, even with the sharp increase, identifies two buy signals here. You do have a downside reversal in here, but then we've got a nice move up again, cross above the 21 EMA. So just a cross above the 21 EMA, that's kind of my personal favorite. And even looking at the QQQ, I found this to be really, really helpful to identify, you know, the starts and beginnings of trends. If you're just going to use one of them, I think for swing traders, I think a cross above and below the 21 EMA, that's a great signal to have turned on with this indicator. And it's kind of one of the main ways of how I identify trends as they begin and end. You can see during this correction, there's a lot of choppiness, but then we finally get that sell that buy signal rather, cross above the 21 EMA, and then we can just ride that trend. And this is right where everybody thought this was going to roll over, and then you get the buy signal the next day, a rally back through the 21 EMA. So it can be a great kind of add spot here within a trend, and it often starts that strong trend as well. And then we see the sell signals come in, a lot of choppiness during that next correction before the next trend comes up the right-hand side of that. So that's pretty much it, and a few examples for the Market Navigator. Again, you can set this up however you'd like. I personally use, again, the individual signals here, but you can just definitely set it up for a combination of signals if you'd like to. And then you want to go through here and select all the different signals that you'd like to add to your toolkit and that you want to add to your charts. And remember, make sure to focus on the price action, overall pattern above all else. These are just kind of objective ways of determining trend and potentially important moments and bars. But you always want to take this into the context of what's actually happening with the price action. That is the most important thing. This can just kind of help you identify those special circumstances that you want to be paying attention to. So hopefully you found this video useful. Let us know your thoughts and feedback down below. How can we improve this indicator? What other kind of metrics would you like us to code in here that you'd like to be able to plot on your chart? Let us know all of that feedback down below and appreciate you watching until the end. And I'll see you guys in future videos. Take care. Bye.